morning, everyone. Good morning, Vimanyans. It's Thursday again. Let us continue our discussion regarding our topic last week, cultural relativism and ethnocentrism. For our recap, ethnocentrism is a belief that one's own culture is better than others. They tend to compare, evaluate, and even judge other people's way based on the values and standards set in one's own culture. Their worldview is based on the beliefs, assumptions, expectations, and values shaped by one's language, behavior, customs, values, religions, and other aspects. So after going through this module, you are expected to, number one, describe your own culture and compare it to the culture of others. Number two, determine the difference between ethnocentrism and cultural relativism. Number three, shows the ill effects of ethnocentrism. And number four, become aware why and how cultural relativism mitigates ethnocentrism. Before we proceed to our lesson, let us watch a short video clip that I downloaded from YouTube, a movie of FPJ entitled Ang Probinsyano, and observe how FPJ or Fernando Foe Jr. become a cultural relativist based on the movie. Okay, after watching the short video clip from Ang Probinsyano by FPJ, can you tell me how Fernando Foe Jr. In the movie become a cultural relativist? Okay, I will give you 1 minute. Comment down your answer, your opinion, your insights or thoughts, how Fernando Poe Jr. became a cultural relativist. So I'll give you 1 minute. Okay, monitor natin yan, ha, yung mga sagot nyo sa ating comment section below. Okay, I will give you 1 minute to comment down your answer, your observation, your insights or thoughts, and observation or opinions, anything about the video clip that you have watched earlier. Ang Probinsyano, no? A movie by FPJ. Okay, so 1 minute starts now. Okay, time is up. Tingnan nga natin yung mga comment nyo, yung mga observation natin, no, sa pinanood natin kanina. How Fernando Poe Jr. in a movie Ang Probinsyano become a cultural relativist. Sino kaya nakapanood ng pelikula na yan? No? Tungkol saan kaya yung movie na yan? No? Napakaganda ang pelikula. No? As we continue on our topic, no, cultural relativism, let us play muna simple game, no? Alam niyo na to. 4 picks, 1 word, no? May apat akong larawan or picture na ipapakita. All you have to do is guess. Ano ba yung gustong iparating, no, na mensahe o konsepto nung apat na larawan na yun? Ano ba ang tinutukoy nung apat na larawan? Okay, handa na ba kayo, Vimanyans? Okay, let us play. So, this is our 4 picks, 1 word. No? Meron tayong apat na larawan, no? Just guess, no? Ano ba ang nais iparating sa atin, no? Ng apat na larawan? Ano ba yung pinapahulaan sa atin dito? Okay? If you are familiar with them, sino kaya yung mga yan? Anong tribo kaya yan? No? I will give you 1 minute. Just comment your answer on our comment section below. Kung alam mo na, ilagay mo na kagad yung sagot mo. Malay mo, tama yan, no? Titingnan natin yung ating mga mag-aaral na nagpa-participate, no, sa ating class discussion. Okay, so timer starts now. Okay, time is up, no? May mga nakahula na kaya? Okay? Sa mga hindi pa nakakahula at hindi pa nila magets, no? Ano ba ang pinapahulaan o sino ba ang pinapahulaan dito sa ating 4 picks one word? Bibigyan ko pa kayo ng isang clue. Okay? Sigurado kapag nakita nyo itong clue na to, mahuhulaan nyo na to less than a minute or wala pa, baka segundo lang makapag-type na kaagad kayo ng inyong mga comment. Okay? Let us see the second, let us see the clue, no? For the 4 picks one word. Okay, so ito ang ating second clue. Your timer starts now. Yun, no? I'm very sure na 100% ng ating attendance nahulaan yung ating 4 picks one word. Kapag hindi mo pa nahulaan yun, ewan ko na lang, di ba? Okay. So obviously, ang pinahulaan ko sa inyo kanina sa ating 4 picks one word ay ang mangyan. So lahat ba tayo kilala or may idea about mangyan? No? Sino ba ang mga mangyan? Saan ba sila makikita? Ano ba yung kanilang kabuhayan? Ano ba yung kanilang customs, traditions, beliefs, religion, language, no? So, alamin natin, kikilalanin natin sila ngayong araw na ito. Okay? For our introduction, no, to Mangyan, no? Let us know, no, their social organization. So, Mangyan is the generic name for the 8 indigenous groups found on the island of Mindoro. So, southwest of the island of Luzon, the Philippines, each with its own tribal name, language, and customs. The total population may be around 280,000, but official statistics are difficult to determine under the conditions of remote areas. Reclusive tribal groups and some having little, if any, outside world contact. The ethnic groups of the island from north to south are Iraya, Alangan, Kadiawan, Taubuwid, called Batangan by lowlanders on the west of the island, Buhid, and Hanunuo. An additional group on the south coast is labeled Ratagnon. They appear to intermarry with lowlanders, no? They also have kind of poetry which is called Ambahan. So, eto, no? Sila yung mga Mangyan, no? May kita sa Mindoro, isa sa mga walong indigenous group, no? Na may kita natin or matatagpuan natin sa Mindoro province. The Mangyans were once the only inhabitants of Mindoro, being coastal dweller at first. They have moved inland and into the mountains to avoid the influx and influence of foreign settlers such as the Tagalogs, the Spanish and their conquest and the religious conversion and raids by the Moro. So they raided Spanish settlements for religious purposes and to satisfy the demand for the slave labor. Today, the Mangyans live secluded in remote parts of Mindoro but eventually come down to the lowlands in order to make usual raids. A certain group of Mangyans in living in southern Mindoro calls themselves Hanunuo Mangyans, meaning true, pure, or genuine, a term that they use to stress the fact that they are strict in the sense of ancestral preservation of tradition and practices. So, ito yung ating mga Mangyan, no? Sila ay coastal dweller, no? Pilit nilang pinepreserve, no, yung kanilang culture, no? So they call themselves, no, a true, pure, or genuine Mangyan. Sila yung mga Hanunuo Mangyan. Let us talk about their language, no? Their language, as in the rest of the Philippines, came from the Austronesian language family. However, even if they are defined as one ethnic group, the tribes use different languages. So on average, they only share 40% of their vocabulary. Their languages are mutually unintelligible, though they share some vocabulary and use Hanunoo script to write. Taubuwid and Buhid are closely related and are unusual among the Philippine languages in having an F phoneme. Taubuwid is divided into Eastern and Western dialects. Western Taubuwid may be the only Philippine language to have no glottal phonemes, having neither. So, yan ha, yan yung ating mga mangyan, no? Meron silang iba't ibang lingwahe, merong iba't ibang salita, no? Based on their vocabulary, no? Pero hindi sila purong Tagalog, eh. May mga kinuha silang salita, no? Sa iba't ibang dialect or iba't ibang tribe, no? Na magkakaiba pa rin. Pero ang sinusunod nila ay ang script or vocabulary or yung lingwahe ng Hanunoo. Kasi sila yung mga pure, sila yung mga genuine na mangyan. So they call themselves na pure, genuine mangyan. Culture and practices. Mangyans live in peaceful societies as compared to the headhunting tribes of North Luzon and the brave, defiant warriors tribes of the South. Social scientists theorize that some societies become peaceful because their system of norms and values reward peaceful behavior but disapprove of aggressive and impulsive behaviors. Peaceful societies are characterized by the egalitarian social organization without status competition between men and without the asymmetric relationship between men and women. Another theory posited that populations adapt, therefore offering a more logical explanation of why Mangyans prefer to retreat in the hinterlands. They accept peaceful submissiveness when they encounter lowland settlers, missionaries, traders, and government officials. So, yung ating mga mangyan, no, napakababait nila. Yung mga mangyan na matatagpuan sa Mindoro province, no, they are peaceful. They are very submissive to lowlanders like missionaries, traders, and government officials. So, let's talk about now their religion. So, indigenous Mangyan religion. So, the Mangyan have a complex spiritual belief system which includes the following deities. So, Mahal na Makaako, the supreme being who gave life to all human beings merely by gazing at them. So, sa isang tingin lang daw ni Mahal na Makaako, no? Lahat ng walang buhay ay magkakaroon ng buhay sa pamagitan lang ng pagtingin daw, no? Sabi ng ating mga indigenous Mangyan. So, Binayi, owner of a garden where all spirits rest. Binayo is a sacred female spirit, caretaker of the rice spirits or Dakalag Paray. She is married to the spirit Balungabon. Dakalag Paray must be appeased to ensure a bountiful harvest. It is for the reason that specific rituals are conducted in every phase of the rice cultivation. Some of these rituals include the panudlak, the rite of the first planting, the rite of the rice planting itself, and the rites of harvesting, which consists of the magbugkos or binding rice stalks, and the pamaguhan, which follows the harvest. So, Balungabon, the spirit aided by 12 fierce dogs, erring souls are chased by the dogs and eventually drowned in a cauldron of boiling water. He is Binayo's husband. So, ito, no, yung ating mga sinasamba, no, na pinaniniwalaan ng ating mga kababayan na Mangyan sa Mindoro province, no? Si Mahal na Makaako, Binayi, Binayo, at si Balungabon. Their traditional religious worldview is primarily animistic. Around 10% have embraced Christianity, both Roman Catholicism and Evangelical Protestantism. So the New Testaments have been published in 6 of the Mangyan languages. Animism. So what is animism? So it is the belief that objects, places, and creatures all possess a distinct spiritual essence. Potentially, animism perceives all things. So animals, plants, rocks, rivers, weather systems, human handiwork, and even words as animated and alive. So ito, no, yung ating mga mangyan, no, 10% sa kanila ay naging Kristiyano na, both Roman Catholic and Evangelical Protestantism, no? So when we say animism, no, nakikita naman natin 'to sa mga movie, no, yung mga tribe, no, sinasamba nila, no, yung puno, yung araw, sinasamba nila yung buhangin or yung lupa. Lahat, when we say animism, no, sinasamba nila, no, kung ano yung nagbibigay sa kanila ng buhay or nagbibigay sa kanila ng masaganang ani or nagbibigay sa kanila ng kaginhawaan. So kung ano man yun, even mga bagay man yan na nilikha or nililok ng kamay ng tao, pwedeng isa rin yan sa mga sinasamba ng ating mga kababayan namang yan, no? So being animism, so ganyan sila, ganyan ang kanilang way of glorifying or praising gods or yung mga deities na tinatawag. Arts and literature. The indigenous Mangyans offer a myriad of culturally rich artifacts that give insight into their culture and trade. The people living in southern Mindoro during the pre-Hispanic era are exceptional in their weaving, pottery, and system of writing. Their clothing differs between genders. So the male generally wear loincloths as covering for the lower body, whereas the female would wear a skirt and a shirt for the top. The terms and materials would differ from tribe to tribe. The exceptional designs would come from the Hanunoos. Their textiles are dyed in indigo blue and have an embroidery design called pakudos at the back and can also be found on their woven bags. So ito yung arts and literature, no, ng ating mga kababayang Mangyan. Magaling sila sa weaving, pottery, and system of writing. And yung kanilang damit, no, sa mga lalaki, sila ay nagsusuot ng loincloth or bahag na tinatawag. Sa mga babae naman ay meron silang skirt at shirt on top, no? May shirt or may damit sila pang itaas. At yung kanilang mga bag naman, especially yung design ng Hanunoo daw, no? Napaka-exceptional or napakagaganda, no? Compared sa other tribe. They have an exceptional design at they dyed their textile in indigo blue and meron silang tinatawag na embroidery na tinatawag na pakudos, no? At ito ay matatagpuan sa likod at mga woven bags na ginagawa ng ating mga kababayang Mangyan. So yan yung kanilang literature. For the continuation, meron pa to eh. Their system of writing called Surat Mangyan is a pre-Hispanic syllabic system and is believed to be of Indic origin. It is still practiced today and still being taught in different Mangyan schools of Oriental Mindoro. The Hanunoos also practice their own traditional poetry called the Ambahan, a rhythmic poetic expression with meter of 7 syllables presented through recitation and chanting or inscribed on bamboo. So ito yung form of writing ng ating Mangyan, no? So huwag kakalimutan yan, ha? Yan ay tinatawag na Surat Mangyan. At yung kanilang tinatawag na poetic expression, no? Tinatawag nila itong Ambahan, no? With 7 syllables presented through recitation and chanting or inscribed, no? On bamboo. So, ito yung kanilang arts and literature. So, kung titingnan natin, no, i-observe natin yung ating mga kababayan nating Mangyan, hindi sila yung iisipin or titingnan natin na wala silang alam or sila ay mga uneducated, no? Kung titingnan natin, meron silang arts, meron silang literature, marunong sila sa poetry, marunong sila sa system of writing, no? Marunong silang mag-weave, no, ng mga damit, no? Marami silang alam. So ngayon, nakikilala na natin unti-unti yung ating mga kababayan na Mangyan na nakatira sa Mindoro Province. Economic system. Their sustenance is farming for their own crops, fruits, and hunting. There were the Iraya Mangyans who isolated themselves from the culture of the Spaniards and the lowland Christians who submitted themselves to a new belief system. These two groups only interacted for economic matters through trading forest goods from the Mangyan and consumer goods for the lowlanders. The southern tribes are more advanced as seen in their use of weaving, pottery, and system of writing. The northern tribes, on the other hand, are simpler in their way of living. Mangyan is mainly subsistence agriculturalist, planting a variety of sweet potato, upland, or dry cultivation, rice, and taro. They also trap small animals and wild pigs. Many who live in close contact with lowland Filipino sell cash crops such as bananas and ginger. So, yan yung ating kabuhayan ng ating mga Mangyan. So, mainly agriculturalist, no? Mahilig sila magtanim, no? Ng mga bungang kahoy, ng mga prutas, no? Mahilig silang mag-hunt, no? Ng mga small animals like wild pigs, no? Yun na makikita sa mga kagubatan, no? At itong mga tanim nila, no? Yung kanilang mga nahuhuling mga hayop, especially yung kanilang pananim, ay ibinababa nila sa kapatagan para makipagpalitan ng kalakal or para ibenta ito, no? Para rin syempre magkaroon sila ng pera, no? May pambili sila ng kanilang pangailangan. Values, customs, beliefs, and tradition. Since the Mangyan are Sweden farmers, their spiritual beliefs are related to their means of livelihood. Agricultural rights suggest the importance of farming and the belief in spiritual beings or forces that can influence a good harvest. So, yung kanilang spiritual beliefs ay nakabase kung ano yung kanilang pinagmumula ng kabuhayan, no? Kung sila ay nagtatanim or sila ay agriculturalist, no? So, ang kanilang sinasamba na deity or gods or bathala ay nakalaan doon. For example, the Hanunoomang yan believe in a supreme being who is referred to as the mahal na makaako, who gave life to all human beings merely by gazing at them. They believe that the universe called Sinukuban, that which is covered or kalibutan, the whole surrounding, has a globular shaped like a coconut. All beings visible or invisible live in this space. So the stratum of the earth is called the Usaka Daga. The Daga or land is surrounded by a border sea which is Dagat. Beyond the Dagat is the Katapusan. So the edge of the universe covered with thick woods and rocks. Nothing lies beyond it. This is the home of the Labang or the horrible creature and evil spirits greatly feared by the Hanunoo. So, ayan, no, yung ating si Mahal na Makaako, siya yung pinaniniwalaan ng ating mga Mangyan na lumikha ng lahat, no, sa pamagitan lang ng pagtingin or gazing, no. Pagtingin ay magkakaroon na ng buhay ang isang bagay, no. At pinaniniwalaan nila na ang mundo raw ay parang isang coconut, no, na may dagat, may lupa, na sa katapusan or sa pinakadulo nito ay mayroong tinatawag na evil or horrible creature, no, na kinatatakutan ng mga Hanunoo. The Labang can take on animal and human forms before killing and eating their victims. They are believed to roam the areas they used to frequent during their mortal existence until they move on to dwell in Binayi's garden, where all spirits rest. Binayo is a sacred female spirit, caretaker of the rice spirits or the Kalag Paray. She is married to the spirit Bulangabon, who is aided by 12 fierce dogs. Erring souls are chased by these dogs, are eventually drowned in a cauldron of boiling water. The Kalag Paray must be appeased. To ensure a bountiful harvest, it is for the reason that specific rituals are conducted in every phase of rice cultivation. Some of these rituals include the panudlak, the rite of the first planting, the rite of the rice planting itself, and the rites of harvesting, which consists of the magbugkos or binding of rice stalks, and the pamaguhan, which follows the harvest. So, ito yung mga kinatatakutan ng mga Hanunoo, no? Yung tinatawag na evil creatures na labang. Sila yung pumapatay at kumakain sa kanilang mga biktima. And, syempre, si Binayo, no? Sacred female spirit, no? Caretaker ng mga rice spirits, no? Or tinatawag na Kalag Paray, no, para maging masagana, maging masigla, no, maging marami pa ang kanilang maging ani, no. Sila ay nag-aalay, no, ang mga Mangyan daw ay nag-aalay ng mga ritual, no. For example, yung tinatawag na panudlak at yung pamaguhan. Batangan cosmogony is less clear. They believe in four deities who are all naked. Two come from the sun and are male. Two come from the upper part of the river and are female. They are believed to be children. According to Kikuchi, 1984, the Paragayan or Diolang plates play an important role in Batangan religious practices. These plates are owned by only a few families and are considered heirlooms. They are essential in summoning the deities to all religions and curing rituals. Among the Mangyans in the southern end of Oriental Mindoro, courtship takes a romantic flavor. Under the magic splendor of the moonlight, young man takes his native guitar and blanket, goes to the girl's hut, and sings to her. The girl comes out and goes with him to a forest. There, in some secluded spot, the man spread out a mat, the girl lies on it, while her suitor sits at her side, pouring out his feelings in love songs the whole night through. The maid answers him in songs also. During a major feast, young men and women court by exchanging love songs. A man will be accompanied by fiddles, guitars, knows flutes and harps as he sings a song expressing his affection for the young women. The young woman answers with a song of her own. Marriages are arranged only after the families of the couple have given their mutual consent. The husband goes to live with his wife's family in order to repay the debt he has incurred by marrying their daughter. So parang kapareho din sa atin, no? Sa mga probinsya, meron din tinatawag na harana, no? Hinaharana ng mga kalalakihan, yung mga kababaihan. Pero dito sa mga mangyan, iba yung kanilang kultura ng pagharana. So dapat daw sasagot yung babae na hinaharana ng kanta, no? The woman answered with a song of her own. So magko-compose siya ng kanta niya, kung ano yung nasa sa loob niya, no? Kung ano yung affection niya tungkol dun sa, or para dun sa lalaki na nangaharana sa kanya. Then kapag okay na, no? Kapag nagkasundo na yung dalawang pamilya, no? Ang lalaki daw ay titira, no? Sila ay magpapakasal at titira ang lalaki sa pamilya ng babae para mabayaran yung kanilang paghihirap, no? To repay the debt has incurred by marrying their daughter. So para mabayaran lahat ng dapat bayaran, no? Sa pagpapalaki sa kanilang anak na babae. Hanunoo believe the kalag are pleased when customary legal rules are strictly followed. Should the people stop sacrificing or observing customs, the kalag will allow evil spirits called labang to afflict the hanunoo. The labang attack a person's soul, causing illness or even death. To combat illness, the hanunoo call in a shaman or priest known in their language as balyanan. The balyanan has control over the spirits living in rocks. The balyanan send these rock spirits to attack the evil spirits causing the illness. So kapag nalabag daw, no, yung customary legal rules, no, ng mga hanunoo, no, magagalit si kalag or si binayo, no, yung ating rice caretaker of rice spirits, no, at siya raw, si binayo raw ay magpapadala ng labang, no, yung mga evil creature na tinatawag sa mga hanunoo na lumabag, no, sa customary legal rules. Okay, na pwedeng mag-cause ng kanilang illness or even death. So para maiwasan yun, ang ginagawa ng mga hanunoo ay tumatawag ng shaman or priest, no, na sa language nila ay tinatawag ding balyanan, na meron silang control over the rock spirits, no. So yung rock spirits na yun ang nagtataboy sa evil spirits, no, sa mga labang para hindi magkasakit or hindi mamatay yung hanunoo na nagkaroon ng illness, no, or nasa bingit ng kamatayan. What do you think of Mangyan social organizations, language, economic systems, arts and literature, values, customs, beliefs, traditions, religions? Can you compare it to yours? Kindly comment down your answer below to our comment section. If we compare our social organizations, our language, our economic systems, our arts and literature, our values, our customs, our beliefs, our traditions and religions, no? What is the difference kaya? No? Ano ba ang pinagkaiba? Is it the same? Is it different? No? Kindly comment your answer on our comment section below. I will give you 1 minute, no? To comment down all your answer on our comment section. Timer starts now. Okay, next. Would you embrace or accept Mangyan's culture, tradition, and beliefs or not? Now, I would like to hear your opinions, your insights about this one. Would you embrace or accept Mangyan's culture, traditions, and beliefs or not? Okay, kindly comment down your answer below to our comment section. I will give you 1 minute no, to comment down all your answers, your insights, or your opinions about this question. Timer starts now. If your answer is yes, okay, that's good. You are being a cultural relativist. But before that, let's define cultural relativism. So, bago ko ibigay sa inyo ang exact definition ng ating cultural relativism, no? Kindly comment down your answer below, no? Ano ba ang pagkakaunawa natin sa isang konsepto, no, ng cultural relativism. So, kanina pa natin ito tinatalakay, no? Kanina pa ako nagbibigay ng halimbawa ng pagiging isang cultural relativist, no? Ano ba ang cultural relativism sa inyong sariling pagkakaunawa muna bago natin ibigay ang eksaktong definition ng ating pinag-aaralan ngayon, no? Ang continuation ng ating topic, no? Cultural relativism. So, I will give you 1 minute again to comment down below your answer about the definition or about your own opinion or your own concept about cultural relativism. Timer starts now. Okay, timer starts, timer stops, and sige, keep on sending all your comments, no? Keep on sending all your answer, no? So, what is cultural relativism? So, gusto ko munang malaman kasi ano ba ang pagkakaunawa nyo, no? Sa idea o konsepto ng isang cultural relativist, no? Based sa ating discussion kanina, no? Sa kanina nung pinanood nyo yung video clip ni FTJ, paano siya naging cultural relativist, no? Kung i-observe nyo, no? Kung pakikinggan nyo maigi yung mga sinabi niya during the conversation with the other tribe, no? At yung ating mga mangyan, kanina sinabi nyo na gusto nyong i-embrace or tanggap nyo, no? Or hindi nyo naman minamasama yung kultura ng mga mangyan na inilahad natin kanina, yung kanilang values, customs, traditions, religions, language, beliefs, no, and others, no, ay niyakap natin. So if you are open, no, sa kultura ng bawat isa or ng bawat society, no, congratulations, no, you are being a cultural relativist, no. Okay, so let us know the exact definition of a cultural relativism. Let us know the definition of cultural relativism. So, cultural relativism is a belief that cultures are equally complex. There is no such thing as superior or inferior culture. Cultural relativism is very important in studying the culture of other people. So, yung ating cultural relativism, no, naniniwala na ang lahat ng kultura ay pantay-pantay. Walang maganda, walang pangit, or walang masama, no, walang mas nakaangat or mas nakabababa na kultura. So, lahat pantay-pantay or equal, no? At ang cultural relativism daw ay napakahalaga dahil kung ikaw ay hindi cultural relativist, no, ay hindi ka magiging open, no, sa kultura ng bawat isa. Okay, so cultural relativism is very important in studying culture of other people. So para maunawaan natin, no, yung mga kultura ng isang society, no, ay kinakailangan natin tumira, makasama yung mga tao na involved, no, para maunawaan natin ano ba yung kultura nila or bakit ba ganito or ganyan yung cultural practices nila, at hindi natin sila i-judge or husgahan sa kanilang kultura or sa kanilang mga ginagawa. So according to thoughtco.com, why recognizing cultural relativism matters? By acknowledging cultural relativism, we can recognize that our culture shapes what we consider to be beautiful, ugly, appealing, disgusting, virtuous, funny, and abhorrent. It shapes that we consider to be good and bad, art, music, and film, as well as what we consider to be tasteful or tacky, consumer goods. The work of sociologist Pierre Bourdieu features ample discussions of these phenomena and the consequences of them. This varies not just in terms of national cultures, but within a large society like the US, and also by cultures of and subcultures organized by class, race, sexuality, region, religion, ethnicity, among others. So, cultural relativism is a way of viewing the beliefs, values, and practices of a culture from its own viewpoint. Another way to say this is that others should understand an individual's beliefs and activities in terms of that person's own culture. Kaya nga sabi natin last week, no, last discussion, bawal ang judgmental. So hindi natin pwedeng i-judge or i-base, no, yung ating kultura sa kultura ng iba na nakinagisna nila. Okay? So dapat maunawaan natin ano ba yung paniniwala, ano ba yung kinagawian, no, ng isang tao or ng isang individual, no, in terms of their own culture. So hindi natin pwedeng i-judge, hindi natin pwedeng sabihin na mas maganda yung kultura na kinagisnan mo compared sa kultura na kinagisnan ng kaibigan mo or kakilala mo. So hindi natin pwedeng ipagkumpara yung dalawang kultura, kasi sabi nga natin, if you are being a cultural relativist, no, there is no superior or inferior culture, there is no bad or good culture. So as long as we understand each other, no, as long as we empathize, no, each others on our own culture, no, nauunawaan natin pareho or inuunawa natin ang bawat isa, okay, there is no conflict, no, walang magiging problema, because we are being open, no, we are not being a judgmental, and syempre you are being a cultural relativist. Like for example, no, in India's child arranged marriage, no. So mga bata pa lang, no, pinapakasal na sila ng kanilang mga magulang. So hindi natin sila pwedeng husgahan kasi yan naman talaga yung kanilang kultura, yan yung kanilang cultural practices. So in India's mayroong tinatawag na child arranged marriage. Cultural relativism promotes greater appreciation of the cultures that an individual might encounter along the way. Cultural relativism is a good way to rehearse the norms and values of a society, a requirement that one must subscribe to, regardless of his or her cultural origin. It means that the function and the meaning of a trait are relative to its cultural setting. So, totoo naman, no, ang cultural relativism, no, it promotes greater appreciation of the culture along the way. Kasi nga, for example, may napuntahan tayong isang lugar or nagawi tayo sa isang lugar or probinsya na ganyan pala or ganito pala yung cultural practices nila. For example, may mga ginagawa sila na hindi natin ginagawa. So, pwede natin siyang i-adapt, no? Pwede natin siyang gawin, no? At sabi nga, it is a good way to rehearse norms. Sabi nga natin dun sa ating last discussion, no, about characteristics of culture, di ba? Culture is shared, culture is learned. So natututunan, na tayo ay ang kultura ay natututunan, ang kultura ay pwedeng ibahagi, no? Along the way, na ibabahagi na sa ating ibang kultura, at yung kultura na yun ay nagiging parte na rin ng ating pamuhay, nakakagawian na rin natin. Like for example, no? This one. Okay, like this one, like this picture, no? Pagmamano. So lahat ba ay nagmamano, no? Pagmamano sa nakatatanda. Okay? May mga lugar kasi na hindi nakaugalian, no? Ang pagmamano. Pero tayo, no? As a Filipino, no? Ito ay part na ng ating cultural practices, yung pagmamano or pagbibigay galang sa mga nakakatanda. Okay? So, sa pagkakaalam ko, tayo lang, no, sa bawat bansa ang may ganitong uri ng kultura na pagbibigay galang sa ating mga elderly o sa mga nakakatanda. To understand better the main difference between ethnocentrism and cultural relativism, an illustration was provided below. O, last time, pinakilala ko sa inyo si Ben as ethnocentric, no? Ngayon naman, ipapakilala ko sa inyo si Lisa as cultural relativist. Okay? Hello? I am Lisa. I am a cultural relativist. I believe that the culture of people must be looked at in terms the world these people inhabit. I try to look at their culture based on what their practices bringing into them. If Eskimos kill their infants sometimes, I believe that there is a practical reason why they do that. That is why for me, culture is relative. There is no right or wrong, and I don't have the right to say if it is good or bad. So, yan si Lisa. Siya ay isang cultural relativist. Sabi niya, ang kultura daw ay pantay-pantay, walang tama, walang mali. No? Nauunawaan niya kung bakit pinapatay ng mga Eskimos yung kanilang mga anak. No? Siguro meron daw practical reason kung bakit nila ito ginagawa. So, si Lisa ay isang cultural relativist, no? Hindi siya isang judgmental or hindi siya nagiging judgmental sa bawat kultura na kanyang nakikita or na tututunan. Okay, sige nga, activity muna tayo. Tingnan natin kung natutunan niyo ba, no? Kung pumasok ba sa inyong kaisipan, no? Ang ugali or characteristic ng isang cultural relativist, no? State your reason why you beg to disagree to the given statements below. You have to remember that you are a cultural relativist. You have to place yourself in the same shoes in order to understand them better. Culture is not good or bad, neither it is right or wrong, but instead it is relative. So, may ipa-flash ako ng mga statement, no? So, gusto kong malaman ano ba yung inyong opinion, no? If you are agree or not agree, no, sa mga ipa-flash kong statement, no? Gamitin natin ulit yung ating comment section sa ibaba, no? Comment your answer, no, your opinions, your thoughts, your insights about the following statements that I will be flashing on our screen. O, remember ha, patandaan, you are a cultural relativist. So, if you're a cultural relativist, no, you must put your self on those shoes of these people. Ibig sabihin, ilalagay niyo yung sarili niyo doon sa sitwasyon na yon, na kayo yung nandoon sa sitwasyon na yon. So, kailangan maramdaman nyo ano yung nararamdaman nila. So, yan yung isang katangian ng cultural relativist. Okay? One society can call another society as evil, such as those nations where terrorists live. These places are called an axis of evil. Okay, do you agree or do you disagree? Kindly comment down on our comment section below your opinion, your thoughts about this first statement. So I will give you 1 minute to comment all your answers on our comment sections below. So remember, you are a cultural relativist. Do you agree or disagree about this first statement? One society can call another society as evil, such as those nations where terrorists live. These places are called an axis of evil. So you have your 1 minute to comment down all your answers, your insights, your opinions for this first statement. Okay, time is up for our second statement. Western culture is superior and opposite of non-Western culture. So, anong masabi natin dito, ano? Sa pangalawang statement. Okay? Kindly comment down all your answers, your comments, or insights about the second statement. I will give you 1 minute again for our second statement. Number three, when you don't say po at opo, you are impolite. So when you don't say po at opo, you are impolite. So comment down your insights, your opinions, your thoughts about the third statement. Timer starts now. Okay, reminder lang ha, you are being a cultural relativist and you beg to disagree to the following statements that I will be flashing. No, I want to know the reasons why you beg to disagree. I want to know your opinions, your comments, or your insights or ideas, no, anything about the following statements. Okay, number four na tayo ha. The Mangyan tribe of Mindoro are backwards people because they are uneducated. The Mangyan tribe of Mindoro are backwards people because they are uneducated. So, okay, a timer starts now. 1 minute ulit tayo. Okay, number five, we have to avoid going to places like Sikihor and Capiz because monster called aswang infest these places. We have to avoid going to places like Sikihor and Capiz because monsters called aswang infest these places. Okay, I'll give you again 1 minute to comment down your reasons, your comments, your insights, and ideas about the fifth statement. Thank you. Iting dalagang bukid, sa lagubang, palakang bukid, and other organisms are not healthy. Iting dalagang bukid, sa lagubang, palakang bukid, and other organisms are not healthy. Okay, timer starts now. Last, Ilocanos are thrifty because they are poor. Ilocanos are thrifty because they are poor. Okay, last na to ha. Comment down your answer, your the reason why you beg to disagree to the last statement, no? Your insights and ideas about the last statement. Timer starts now. After hearing all your comments, insights, thoughts, and opinions on all the issues addressed on our topic, cultural relativism and ethnocentrism, I am glad to know that most of you are being a cultural relativist. Okay, cultural relativism helps bridge the gap between and among the Filipino communities. It eliminates or lessens Filipino ethnocentrics. Observe the golden rule, you reap what you sow. Let us correct our ethnocentric attitude and behavior done of others. Every individual is unique and we must respect everyone's uniqueness. Bawal judgmental, eliminate judgmental mentality, and we must embrace culture of our own society. So yan ha, sana nabago ang inyong mga pananaw regarding Filipino ethnocentrics or regarding ethnocentrism. So marami tayo, no? Before, unaware tayo na tayo pala ay nagiging ethnocentric, no? After hearing all the lesson, after studying cultural relativism and ethnocentrism, no, sana naunawaan natin ano bang pagkakaiba. At after nitong lesson natin, sana alam nyo, no, kung saan ba tayo dyan sa dalawa, kung tayo ba ay pipiliin pa ba natin maging isang ethnocentric or tayo ay magiging isang cultural relativist. Before we end our session, I would like to leave you these two quotes that I downloaded na from Google. Okay, always put yourself in other's shoes. If you feel that it hurts you, it probably hurts the other person too. Sometimes people won't understand how you feel until it happens to them, until they experience the pain. So, laging tatandaan na, always put yourself on the same shoes, no? If you are being a cultural relativist, no, dapat open tayo lagi sa kultura ng bawat isa, no, sa kinagawian, kinagisnan, or anything, no, yung mga cultural practices, no, hindi natin sila dapat i-judge based on their culture. Dapat maunawaan natin yung mararamdaman nila kapag sinabihan natin sila ng masasama or masasakit na salita. Okay? Reminder lang, V-Manians, no, yung ating Google link isi-send ko mamaya after ng ating video. At pinagsama ko na yung ating assessment at yung ating reflection sa isang Google link. So pag nagsagot kayo ng assessment, nandun na rin sa susunod na section yung reflection. Okay? And next week, be prepared, no, sa ating summative test for our week 1 to 4. Magkakaroon tayo ng short review, yung Google link, no, through Google Meet. Yung Google link, i-send natin yan an hour before ng ating review. So, yung mga gusto lang mag-join sa ating review, pwedeng mag-join. Yung mga ayaw, or alam naman nila, or kaya naman nila, sa tingin nila, kaya nilang ipasa yung exam, no problem, kahit hindi na kayo mag-join sa ating Google Meet review session. So, hanggang dito na lang ulit, V-Manyan. See you next week. See you next Thursday. God bless us all.